Short handy hints video from A&D. We're going to go through how to set the upper and lower target limits on the very popular HTCL compact packing scale. These are used primarily for manual packing operations, especially, for example, strawberries, raspberries, blueberries, where product has to be packed manually because it's very valuable and fragile. And the key here is you've got a traffic light system to reduce overfill. So if it ain't green, it ain't right. So you don't want any red lights for underweight, and you certainly don't want any orange lights for overweight, which is basically profit going out of the door of the packing shed. Now the scale itself ships in a nice little hard container for protection when you're not using it in the off season. There's also a couple of little interchangeable color tabs there if you want to coordinate rows of packers, for example. So opening the packaging and taking the scale out of its case, basically flick the lever at the back and we're away. So I'll put that to one side. So looking at the scale itself, like I said, very, very compact form factor. It's designed to be run on either batteries if you've got no power. So there's six AA batteries inside, or you can run it on a mains power pack, which we also ship with the scale. Coming with it is a quick start guide to show you how to review the target settings. And obviously for much more detail, there's a full instruction manual. When I turn this scale on, it'll come on in the last program that I had it set on before I turned it off. Now there's actually 9 sets of set point values you can save in here, so it's easy to change between different punnet sizes if you wanted to pack different packs in the one operation. So at the moment, I believe it's set for 125 to 150 grams in memory number one. So obviously that big pile of business cards is way too much. So if we take them away, we come down under 150, it'll obviously show green, and if we go down under 125, it'll show low. So how do we change the setting values? Firstly, you want to press the enter key and it'll show what the current memory is. If I press mode, it will just increment between the 9 different ones. So if I now want to create one in number 3, I bring up number 3 and I'll press the re-zero button, it'll show me the screen for the low value, hence the low light is indicated. At the moment, there's nothing there, so it's all zeros. Now, because this is a 1 gram scale, this is the ones, tens, hundreds, and thousands column. Essentially, if we want to start changing the values, we'll press enter. One of the digits will start flashing. We press mode, it moves it across. Let's say we want to change this one to between 200 and 220 grams as my target packing weight. Once the digit's flashing that you want to change, press the re-zero button until it says the right number. If you miss it, just keep pressing it, it'll go right at ground and back to where you started again. So that's pretty easy. So we've got 200 set as our low limit, hit enter, and now it'll ask us to set the high value. Again, same screen, press enter to make one flash, use the mode key to go across. We're gonna change this one by pressing the re-zero to 2, go across one more, press that again. That's now 220 grams is my high limit. Enter, and we're away. So basically that's now saved in memory number 3. If I turn the scale off, so now when we turn the scale back on again, it'll come up and we can just double check if you like, but the memory is the one that we last changed, which is memory number 3. And now when we put on the pile of business cards, which is 174 grams, that's now underweight because we set 200 to 220 as our target. So there is a very easy explanation of how to set the target weights. Obviously, if you get stuck or you need any assistance, you can contact your local A&D office or your local A&D authorized partner, and they'll be glad to help you. I hope you found this informative. Thanks for watching.